Right, now, what are you three lads up to? Not a lot, especially this guy. You appear to be using a trumpet as a telescope, which didn't work out well for you. And what prize do we have? Ooh, gold pick of Falfoot. Nice. Now, let's have a sniff around these here ruins. See if we can't find our way into the basement. Alright, come on, soldier boys. I need your help. I'm not sure I can parry this guy. But we can certainly bleed him. Excellent job. Well done, gang. There's friend Sellen.
Tarnished, are we?
Yeah, we'll chat with you, although...
You here? Ah, I dare say your proclivities are far from ideal. Oh well, perhaps nurture will defy nature. With a bit of luck.
Yeah, she knows that we're Egypts. But she's got a quest, so we'll just chat to her anyway, just in case. Yes, quite. Indeed. Yes, rather. Now, where else can we go and wreck up a nice easy boss? We haven't done Limgrave Tunnels yet. But we have done Groveside Cave, by the look. Did we finish Groveside Cave, though? And is that indicating that we've not done those catacombs? Maybe. Right, so it's still showing up on the map as a blue thing. But maybe once we've grabbed ourselves the Sight of Grace, that'll go away. Let's find out. Yeah. Looks like it's cleared that off the map now. So we should always talk to those guys, even if we're not immediately planning on going into the catacombs, I think. Now, Boglins versus Dagger. It's not a good fight for us. But do we have a lot of choice? Oh, God. That's like almost blood loss after one combo, which is horrible. Yeah, we're not going to be parrying these guys much, I don't think. Or are we? Maybe that's the way. We should probably try at least, shouldn't we? But we do also have the bow, which is very nice, so we can flink this guy. Bring him down to our level. Maybe a parry. Or maybe not. Yeah, that doesn't seem to be working. They just swing too quick. Are these guys any good at climbing ladders? All I know is my gut says probably not. See you later, Boglins. Worst case scenario is they can climb ladders and we can just sort of knock them off. Yeah, I see you. Oh god, they're all coming. Maybe they can. Yoink. And snatch. And roll. And some more rolls. Yeah, then climb ladders, all right. And they could probably drop down there. But we've already taken out that lad, so that's fine. And then we'll snatch a bit of that and cheese it. Should we go straight for the boss? Yes. Oh god, it's cat thing. Get him, lads. Doubt this guy can be bled. It's made of rocks. Rocks generally don't bleed. Got a decent turning speed on that thing. Flattened both my lads. But yeah, not much of a problem with a pair of decent summons. And our reward is more summons. Okay. And we've still not got enough for a level, because, yeah, we need like 7,000-8,000 for a level now. But that was fun nonetheless. Maybe if we used a bunch of runes, we could just get ourselves up to another level. That could be nice. So have we got 3,400 runes worth of stuff?
Well, I took you no matter to lay out your own.
Also though, let's check. Could level up our short bow a bit. Could level up our buckler a bit. Yeah, because we've got 1600, 2800. 8816, that's more than enough. Now, more dex. It's more damage. When we're not bleeding things, our damage isn't amazing. But then, I'm tempted to just go to Vigor 40 on everyone before... Yeah, Vigor 40 on everyone, unless I need more weapons. More stats to use a new weapon. Maybe. We'll see. Also, we should probably speak to Hugh again. Oh no, he doesn't sell weapons. It must just be the maiden husks that do. Dagger, 400. Scimitars could be fun though as well. Rock a dual scimitar build maybe. But yeah, let's buy a bog standard dagger, because it might be fun to have that on the offhand. And then apply an ash of war to it that gives it some sort of effect, like frostbite maybe. Not that we've got any frostbite related yet, I don't think. Ashes yet. We've got Bloody Slash.
No matter.
Let's see. Sacred Blade, if we wanted to add some faith to it for some reason. Blood Dagger. So we could give it slightly lower dex scaling, but it would give it arcane scaling. Yeah, maybe we'll rock a double blood dagger build for the moment. That could be fun. Yeah, let's find some random goobers here in Leonia and see what our blood daggers can do for us. Don't know why I chose this spot, I just thought it might be interesting to see something new. The Church of Iris. Ooh. Well, grab that sacred tear, because it's just right there. Who are you?
You're tarnished, aren't you? Then, perhaps you could spare some runes. Believe it or not, I studied Flintstone sorceries at the Academy of Rhea Lucaria. For a small donation, I'd be happy to share my knowledge.
Yeah, yeah, we've got 10 runes.
Well, bless you, bless you. You're a true saint. My name is Topes.
Topes.
You're interested.
Fops.
I can teach you sorceries, as promised. Only, none of them are particularly great.
Well, you're not really selling them very well, are you? And yeah, they are pretty mediocre, although Starlight. It's kind of cool.
Apologies, friend. I'm afraid my meager sorceries are no match for your generosity. Oh, right. I can tell you what I know about this place. That should help a bit.
Yeah.
You've seen that structure to the north, towering over the water. That's the Academy of Rhea Lucaria, where we study glintstone sorceries. Only its doors have been closed for quite some time now. After they declared they wouldn't interfere with the shattering, the Academy cast repelling seals on the east gate leading to the capital, and the south gate leading here. As you might have guessed, the seals are still active, making entry to the Academy impossible without a glintstone key. And so I'm stuck here. A fledgling sorcerer with little chance of acquiring a key. When they cast the seals, I'd just popped out. And now I'm uprooted from my place of learning.
I'm not sure about that.
You've taken an apprenticeship with Sellen. Well, that is something. Sellen was well known. The most promising sorceress in the history of the Academy.
Really?
I followed her at school. But there may as well have been an ocean between us. But Sellen was expelled from the Academy, accused of unthinkable treatment of certain sorcerers, under the name of the Graven Witch. I still don't believe the accusations. The illustrious Sellen would never do such things. Why not find yourself a glintstone key? Without one, you can't pass through the Academy, and you'll never reach the Erdtree capital. And if you find an extra glintstone key, perhaps, once you've tied up all your loose ends. And I can be very patient. Would you consider donating it to me? I know it. I'm a bluntstone. Nary a hint of talent for sorcery. But still, my place is at the Academy.
We'll see what we can do, friend. We'll see what we can do for you. But for now, I want to test out my stabby daggers. Let's have a look. To the north. Oh, is that Site Grace? Or is that the one we've already got and it's just telling us to go this way? That's fine. So I guess that's the Academy he's referring to over there in the distance, but it's a bit hard to see in this murk. And there's a map in this direction. Now, you're not going to bleed, are you? Anything in here, because it's a graveyard. And skelly bones are very much known for their inability to bleed. Is this safe? Can this be parkoured? I'm going to say that's a no. Nothing else to do in these ruins, really, is there? It's just literally just a hole. Hello. Divine fortification. So there's a lot of faith stuff around here. I guess we'll have a look at that. Just because we've not seen it before on anyone. Oh, it's an incantation. Increases holy damage negation. Meh. That's the sort of thing that you slot for like one or two bosses, and that's about it. The Weeping Everjail requires a stone sword key. Maybe we'd get bodied, so let's just move on and see what this church has got to offer. It's got headless dudes. Headless dudes guarding the entrance. It's the fourth church in America. Okay. Sacred tear, thank you. And we'll use that now. So we've got a walking mausoleum over there. And a nice beach down here. With an army. Look at all those lads. Beach is covered in boys. Good grief, they're everywhere. Now, anything of merit in this direction on the beach? Once again, we're back to looking for secret caves on the beach. We're finding loot. The Golden Room 2. So, practically the least spectacular loot we could have found. Why are these land octopuses so good at jumping? And yes, octopuses is an acceptable plural of octopus. Octopodes is also valid. Octopi though. No, it's not a Latin word. You should be pluralizing it with an I. But at the same time, people are going to know what you mean if you call them octopi. So go ahead, knock yourself out. Ooh, Golden Room 5. That's mildly more impressive. I suppose if you want to test out any AoE spells, this might be a fun spot to do. But yeah, what happened on this beach? Did a ship get wrecked up here or something? And that's why there's just so very many buggers around. Maybe. Merchant friend!
It's been an age. How can I help?
It's been an age since I've seen anyone, because I live in the middle of bloody nowhere. So we'll grab the lantern. Is it worth grabbing anything else or not? So I hand it. Shame he's got no armour.
Have a safe journey.
We'll leave you for now, I think. But we will put our lantern on the traditional left slot. Left for lantern. Because they both begin with L. So we can knock off that mausoleum just to stop the bloody ringing. Might be worth it. That. Cheese it. No, we're just trying to clean your feet, my friend. I wasn't expecting that foot to move again so fast. Hence, almost getting squashed. I wonder if it was deliberate to make the bells as annoying as possible so that people would come over and try and kill these dudes. Because I watched a stream where someone just wasn't killing the mausoleum for like ages. And it was driving chat wild. They were not impressed. Whoops. Cheeky boy. Nearly squashed us. Still not entirely clear how a walking mausoleum came to exist. But there you go. Ready the lantern. pays for itself, allowing us to sneak along this cliff and look out for the old hidden cave. Once again, there isn't one, but every now and again there is. And when there is, it's hype. What else is there to really do in the peninsula, though? It's not the biggest area in the world. There isn't a tree over there. Maybe it's got a boss that we can fight. Ooh, didn't even need two shots on that lad. So what tower do we have here? Ooh, whoops. Stop it, you lot. Good. Got them in the end. Don't want to worry about those lads for now, I don't think. The Tower of Return. That doesn't sound ominous. Yeah, I mean, I already know what this is about. So we'll go up and have a look anyway. It's a chest. Perfectly innocent chest. Except, whoops, it's another transport. And this time we're not in Caelid. This time we are in somewhere a bit deeper in the game. Yeah. Our map has zoomed out somewhat. Don't think anyone's found a way to survive that drop yet. So we can't really explore this end game part of the map. But there is a site of grace. Thankfully. Because if there wasn't, then we couldn't shake off this you can't fast travel debuff that we've currently got. Now, there's also a big lad whom we could possibly fight. I've heard that people have fought this big lad at low level, but I'd rather not. There might also be a chest though, so so let's have a sneaky peek. Okay, big lad's woken up. We're doomed. So let's just run over here and loot this chest. Blessed Jew Talisman. Okay. Oh, jeez. I thought we might be able to get in close enough to avoid that swing. I was incorrect. Now, there's not a lot we can do with those 2,000 runes, but we might be able to get them back pretty easy. What's this Blessed Jew Talisman all about, though? Slowly restores HP. Guess it can help save us a bit here and there on the old healing, but nothing major. Where's our runes? They're going to be over by the chest, aren't they? Yes. So we'll grab them, and then we'll sneak in here. And we'll get buffed. Of course we will. Stab, 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 stab. And no, we got buffed again. I was kind of hoping we could stun him, knock him down. Didn't seem to work, so we'll just cheese it. And go back somewhere more sensible. There's a cave. How do we get to said cave easily? Head south from the church pilgrimage, perhaps? Or there's the ailing village, maybe? What is that? Was that the demi-human forest ruins? And if it was, why doesn't it show up as anything particularly interesting on the minimap? A unless we jogged in and out of it so quickly. No, it's different ruins. The Witchbane ruins. Nice. Oh, jeez. It's a ball of faces. I was talking about them earlier. Nope. Anything valuable here? Oh, hello. That doesn't look promising. Amber Shard.
It will do no good, I swear it. And yet you persist. You frothing degenerates.
Okay, that doesn't sound good. How many arms have you got? Get out of it. Arm boy. Sellen, is this you? It looks like Sellen. I mean, it's a bit unfortunate that she's down here like this, so maybe we'll... On the one hand, I might want to help her, but on the other hand, I don't know if we can right now. And we don't want to accidentally ruin a quest. Amber Shard strikes from behind with projectile fired from distance. Sounds cool. Maybe we'll equip it once we've got a bit more int. And as for you... Yeah, no, we don't want any of that. But can we do anything about you from down here? Without getting hit, I mean. Kind of. You don't seem very weak against magic, so maybe we'll just bugger off. Do a bit of the old loot and run if we can. Anything worth looting? God. That's one pissed off ball of faces. Aha. So that guy told us about the Tower of Return, but we've already discovered it, so it's all good. And yeah, Witchbane Ruins, and it is Sellen, lovely. Well, not lovely for Sellen. What's this cave? The Tombswood Cave, or the Tombswood Cave. Is it Tombswood? I think it's Tombswood. What you gotta say for yourself, Lance? Poison ahead. Hmm. That bodes well.